The Ministry of Finance has introduced a 200 billion shilling small business recovery fund to support small and medium-scale enterprises to recover from negative effects of COVID-19. The government is offering 100 billion shillings to this fund, which will run jointly with commercial banks that will also contribute 100 billion shillings to create cheap credit for struggling small businesses. Take a look.
In a bid to support economic recovery following the disastrous effects of COVID-19, the permanent secretary in the Ministry of Finance, who doubles as the secretary to the Treasury, Ramadan Gobi, has unveiled a 200 billion shilling small business recovery fund to support small and medium-scale enterprises.
Government invested over 558 billion and in UDC over 138 billion. To co-invest with some of these large businesses. But now there are these smaller businesses, downtown Kampala, in the whole of this countryside, like agro, you have a small agro processing kind of plant. You are downtown Kampala selling a few things and so on. Now, these had been left out. So His Excellency the President, on this realization, directed us to create a fund of 200 billion, which is going to work in the mode of SCF.
The fund is going to run as a joint venture between the government and commercial banks, with each party contributing 100 billion shillings. The aim is to offer credit to SMEs at a very low interest rate.
The internal discussions are ongoing. We have actually finalized most of them. Very soon, my Minister of Finance is going to announce the modalities we are going to pass through to borrow this money at very good interest rate, and then pay back also within an extended period, so that we can support these businesses to recover. They are the ones which employ a few other Ugandans. They are paying tax. They are also supporting livelihoods of people.
Gobi has also disclosed plans to use Uganda Development Corporation to bail out struggling businesses which employ many Ugandans and big exporters. In this model, the Uganda Development Corporation will co-invest in these enterprises and pull out after enabling them to regain their muscle.
We are going to put money in UDC. Already UDC has been doing this. We want to capitalize them further to come and buy some shares in that company. You run it together, the company owners, the directors, and UDC, until you recover. When you recover, if you don't want government to be a shareholder, government, you will pay them and it pulls out.
But Chira Municipality Member of Parliament Ibrahim Semuju Nganda has cautioned the government that the model of tokenism will never achieve economic recovery. It will only promote a dependency syndrome in the economy. He asked the government to focus on creating an enabling environment for the economy to reopen and operate effectively.
They know the problem, but they don't know the solution, or they deliberately miss it. Because there is no country that is going to grow by taking money from those who have, and then you go and distribute on the street as if you are distributing relief. So that's what government is doing, behaving like a World Food Program. World Food Program will never solve problem of hunger, but it gives you food temporarily until you begin growing yours. What the government is doing is to become a World Food Program, to distribute food and thinking that that will end the food shortage. They need to create environment for people to produce in the villages.
Gobi also announced a move to introduce a law to regulate business competition in the private sector. He noted that monopolistic tendencies have affected some sectors of the economy, where giants are making it difficult for new competitors to come up.
In every country, they have what they call antitrust laws or antitrust policies. Don't overtrust a business person that he will do the right thing. So competition law is to encourage competition and ensure that you stop cartel. Cartel is where businesses collude to not to compete in prices, but only compete in quantities, for example, by allocating themselves zones.
Africell Uganda and Smart Telecom announced closure of business in Uganda, which created fears of oligopoly in the telecom sector. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.